Hello everyone. As you can see, I have two Excels here. One is the single tool version and the other one has all the five tool heads. I would like to give you an update both about the shipping of the Excel and also about the latest development and changes we've made in the past few weeks. So in December, we sent the single tool beta units to our external testers and we also continued our internal testing. But believe me, we really want to ship the machines as soon as possible. And while we still wait for some parts, we are using the time to improve the printer. So let's get to it and talk about the specific changes we've made so far. First and foremost, we improved the parts for mounting the X carriage and the Y carriages, plus the extruder. We printed them from carbon-filled polycarbonate, so they are much stiffer. Also, the profile, which supports the linear rail over here, is made much stiffer. And this helps to eliminate a lot of ghosting and improves the overall performance of the printer. In the last development diary, I mentioned that we had issues with the suppliers of linear rails. And I have some good news because after many months of testing, we finally have two equally good options for the rails. So there will be not a problem in the future. We also made some changes to the frame and side panel of the printer, because our tests have shown that at certain speeds, the large side panels can resonate. We are making small optimization to dampen the vibrations. This in turn will make the printer much quieter. If you take a good look at the steel sheet, you might notice that it looks slightly different than the one we've shown previously. Because during our testing, we discovered something that is pretty obvious in the hindsight. The part of the steel sheet extending over the edge of the heatbed acted as a heatsink, and the heatbed had a hard time compensating for the heat dissipation. It's right here. So we experimented with different shapes, and it still needs to be easily removable, and we ended up with a sheet that looks like this. The Excel is equipped with Wi-Fi, and because there's a good possibility that you will have your machine in a workshop or in a large office where the wireless signal might not be strong enough, we added a large external antenna to make the reception as good as possible. Of course, there's an Ethernet as well, but the printer does not require any network access to operate, only if you want to. And if you want, you can also connect it with the Prusa Connect. We have decided to ship the Excel with 0.6mm nozzle by default, compared to 0.4mm on most machines these days. In our opinion, it's a better option for large and durable models. But the 0.6mm nozzle works great even for smaller models, thanks to the recently ported Arachne and Prusa slicer. Well, let us know what you think about this. But we also have other nozzle options available along with a special adapter, so you can use any V6 style nozzle with the XL. Let's talk about the tool changer now. I have some models over here. We expect one of the popular combinations will be PLA with water soluble supports from PVOH or PVA. And the XL can handle these with ease. There is no cross contamination in the nozzle, which would compromise the integrity of the PLA model. And there is also no need to wipe excessive amounts of filament to clean the nozzle. Just a small priming tower so the start is sharp on the model. And this one is also pretty cool because you don't always have to use the expensive PVOH for water soluble supports. Instead, you can combine PLA and PTG, like in this case, and because you don't have to dry it out, it's cheap and everyone has it at home. I also have a classical demo of a rigid and flexible model in one go. The Excel is made for all day, everyday printing with different materials in the same print compared to the single nozzle material switching. The tool changer will be soon shipped out to the beta testers. We needed them first to have the single tool testing done, and now we need them to go through the upgrade path. The current state of the market and extremely long lead times in various parts of the world are making things really hard, but we can't blame all delays on it. We could have done things differently and we are sorry to keep you waiting and keep moving the start of the shipping. The first single tool Excels will leave the factory in March. We are now starting to put together Excel sub-assemblies without the missing parts. In the first few weeks, we are planning to ship just a couple of hundred single tools full assembled XLs, but the production will increase shortly after that. As for the multi-tool machines, we expect to start shipping them shortly after the beta tests, which will take about 2 months. It is impossible for us to create shipping table just right now because we don't know when and how well people finalize their orders. But once you pay for the order and finish it, we will give you at least an estimate shipping date. Now let's talk about the process of finishing the order. We will send you an email in advance that your reservation is now ready to be turned into the final order. You can edit the shipping address, add more items to your order, and select the shipping method. However, you can't increase the number of the XLs, but you can decrease it. There is no deadline for converting the reservation into an order right now. The date of the reservation is decisive, and as soon as you pay for it, you will jump into the right place in the queue. If you want to upgrade your reservation from a single tool into a multiple tool heads, don't finish your order until we start shipping the multi-tool XLs. After the shipment of multi-tool printers starts, you will be able to adjust the configuration of the XL, both the number of tool heads, whether it is semi-assembled or fully assembled, etc. I hope this update answered your questions and gave you better overview of the current situation with the XL. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments or tune into the Prusa Life podcast. Thank you for watching and happy printing.